So I think the language in this question is a bit hard to understand, with clowns telling the truth and jokers being liars. So I'm just going to translate everything into new language, and I'm just going to call clowns truth tellers and jokers liars. It's less confusing. So what does the question say in this language? P says Q is a liar. They always lie. Q says R always lies. And R says that P is a truth teller. P always tells the truth. It's as if they're standing in a circle and making a comment about the person in front of them, about whether they're a liar or a truth teller. S sort of stands outside this circle and looks at the overall picture, looks at P, Q, and R, and S says exactly two of P, Q, and R always lie. Well, let's see what the consequences of these remarks are. So we've established we understand these statements that P, Q, and R and S all make, but we don't know who is a truth teller and who is a liar. But let's try and explore and try and find out. So P might be a truth teller. So just suppose that P is a truth teller. P says that Q is a liar, but P is a truth teller, so P is telling the truth, so Q is indeed a liar. Q says that R is a liar, but Q is a liar, so Q isn't telling us the truth when Q says that R is a liar, so R is a truth teller. R says that P is a truth teller, so that's true. S looks at these people, and S makes the remark that exactly two of these people are liars. Now, that's not the case. So S must be a liar. And that answers the question, actually, because the answer is that exactly two of these characters are truth tellers and exactly two are liars. You want to be careful, maybe. If you're in a hurry, you know the answer. But let's just check. So let's suppose instead that P is a liar. P is a liar and says that Q is a liar. So that's wrong. Q is a truth teller. Q says that R is a liar and Q is a truth teller. So that's true. So R is indeed a liar. Does it make sense? R says that P is a truth teller. But they're not. So yeah, that fits with R being a liar. S looks at this lot and says, that of P, Q and R, two of them are liars. That's right. So S must be a truth teller. And we conclude, as before, that two of these characters are liars and two are truth tellers. And translate that back into the language of clowns and jokers, and you're done.